Hello everyone, happy morning, a very good morning. I hope and I believe all of you are doing well. Am I audible and visible? Am I audible and visible to everyone? Yes, so today in this episode 6, so if you remember, this is episode 6 of your rank booster revision for the NEET PG exam. We have 5 episodes so far. This is the 6th episode. In the 5 episodes, I have given you the links of all the classes in one of the Telegram messages. You can check there, the rank booster, where we had first 2 on ophthalmology. We have discussed your nerve fiber classification mnemonics. We have discussed your bacterial toxin K mnemonics, and yesterday we had discussed your Vigors diagram for CVS physiology, right? And today is the 6th episode. What is the plan for the rest of the day for today after this session is right? So you have 11 a.m. today on the Unacademy Plus platform, that is only for the subscribers. We are, I'm starting with a batch, which is a 5-day batch. So starting today, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15th of August. Every day, 11 to 12, 11 a.m. to 12 p.m., a 1-hour class, which will be based on the mnemonics, the tricks, basically for the topics which are frequently asked. We had it like the last year as well. So we will be doing this year as well, and it will help you get those extra marks, some tricks that you should know in the examination hall. Now, the topic for today, because we are starting with pharmacology in the revision timetable, so I've decided to today cover your general pharmacologic and numericals, right? No matter, even if you have read it before, we tend to get confused and it's important to revise it before the exam. So your calculations based on your volume of distribution, maintenance dose, your T half, your first order, zero order kinetics, that is what we will be discussing in the today's session. And then we will decide the topics for the rest of the sessions. 5 p.m. like every day, your free live class. It's today it's going to be your emergency case discussion in radiology. The case that was posted on YouTube channel. So we'll discuss why that was the answer. I'm not disclosing what the answer is and why the other options are not the answer. That is what we'll be discussing in today's 5 p.m. class. It's just a half an hour class. So please be there on time so that you do not miss on anything. Right. So today we are going to discuss the concept of SAG, that is basically your serum ascites albumin gradient. Let me simplify this for you, and after this session, I would love if all of you go back and solve the MCQs from your respective resources as well. And let me know if this session helped you in solving those questions. Yesterday, after the Vigors diagram, the cardiac cycle ka session, thank you so much for everyone who messaged saying that you were able to solve all the questions based on the session. And that really motivates me to work more, right? Tomorrow 9:30 a.m. in our rank booster revision series, which will be on Unacademy YouTube channel, the topic for tomorrow is your types of cartilage. So basically based on your histology images, it's a very, very important topic. How do you differentiate hyaline, elastic, fibrocartilage? Where is it present? A quick short session on the types of cartilage, histology based session. Tomorrow 9:30 a.m. is our topic for discussion. Okay, so after this session, I'll see you everyone at 11 a.m. on the Unacademy platform for general pharmacology calculations. Okay, first question, a pre-test question that we have generally. What do you think is the answer to this? Ascites with low SAG value is seen in which of the following? Ascites with low SAG value is seen in peritoneal carcinomatosis, liver metastasis, post-sinusoidal obstruction syndrome, or is it your congestive cardiac failure? Where do we see low SAG? So I'll tell you all the mnemonics, the cheat codes to remember this topic. Yes. Yes. So I see a lot of mixed answers here. Yes, Yasmin, the 11 AM class is only for the plus subscribers of Unacademy. Why are there a lot of mixed answers here? A lot of mixed answers here. Peritoneal carcinomatosis, liver metastasis, post sinusoidal obstruction syndrome, or is it your congestive cardiac failure? The easy cheat code to know this, you know, even if you have not read somewhere, you must have read at least that your SAG is related to the presence or absence of portal hypertension. Just remember at least this one point, ki SAG is something related to portal hypertension. Whether it's high SAG or low SAG, we will see that. Now look at the causes: liver metastasis, post sinusoidal obstruction, congestive cardiac failure. So when you have congestive cardiac failure, by the back pressure, the liver is also affected. So in all of this, the liver is affected. Only it's your peritoneal carcinomatosis, which is not related to the liver. So that is the answer. So the cheat code, very, very important to use in your exam, is your odd man out. Whenever you get such questions, try categorizing three. Like, these are the causes where the liver is affected, basically portal hypertension happening. This is where the liver is not affected. The answer is A. Okay, the answer is A. Right? Your post sinusoidal obstruction syndrome is a cause of portal hypertension. Now, a cheat code to remember this. First, let us understand what is serum, ascites, albumin gradient, or gap. As the term says, it is serum minus ascites albumin. So SAG is calculated by the serum albumin minus the albumin level of ascitic fluid. That is what the gradient is. So if this is the serum albumin, this is the ascites albumin, what is the difference? It is as easy as that. That is your gradient. Now, when will this difference increase? When will the gradient be high? Serum albumin minus your ascites albumin. When will this difference increase? When either you increase your serum albumin levels, right? So when you increase your serum albumin levels, this gradient will increase, as you can see here. When you increase the serum albumin level, the SAG, the gradient will increase. And when does your serum albumin increase? Serum albumin will increase. So you have albumin in the plasma. When will it increase? When you have your hemoconcentration, basically your plasma volume is decreasing. So if you have a plasma volume of 1 liter, and if you decrease it to 0.5 liter, here because of the concentration, the albumin will be high. So basically, when you are sending the fluid out of the blood vessel, relative concentration of albumin is happening. That is when your serum albumin is increasing, and that is when the SAG will increase. Okay, that is when the SAG will increase. Now, what will cause this fluid to go out of the blood vessel? Your increase in hydrostatic pressure or your decrease in hydrostatic pressure? What sends the fluid out? What sends the fluid out? Is it the increase in hydrostatic pressure or the decrease in hydrostatic pressure? What will send the fluid out of the blood vessel? It is your increase in hydrostatic pressure. That is the pushing wala pressure, right? So the increase in hydrostatic pressure. So basically your SAG, high SAG, right, your increase in hydrostatic pressure will increase your serum albumin, that will increase your SAG. This increase in hydrostatic pressure is basically in your hepatic sinusoids. From the hepatic sinusoids, the fluid going out. So SAG indicates your pressure in the hepatic sinusoids. So when will you have high SAG? When there is portal hypertension. Okay, when there is portal hypertension. So just to remember, so that the trick is remember this image. I've put a visual for you so that you remember this. Okay, so that you remember this. SAG, if you know. Okay, so SAG, agar aapko pata hai Hindi mein ya Punjabi mein, basically SAG is your this vegetable which is made from palak, that is spinach. So this is your SAG. And SAG, I put this image of spinach, that is basically your palak. Okay? So So remember that SAG is P. That means it is portal hypertension. Increased SAG, high SAG is basically your portal hypertension. It is basically your portal hypertension. So SAG is, that is your portal hypertension. That is your portal hypertension. Yes, Shifra sir. So the SAG or Makke di Roti. That is what it is. So what do we, just remember this, SAG, increased SAG is your portal hypertension. Decreased SAG is your non-portal hypertension wale causes. Non-portal hypertension wale causes. I'll tell you the mnemonic for that as well. So remember that basically SAG is a calculation. Why do we use this SAG? To determine the cause of ascites. And this lets us know whether the ascites is due to portal hypertension or not. If it is due to portal hypertension, you have increased SAG. Okay, you have increased SAG. How do we calculate? SAG is gradient serum albumin minus albumin of ascitic fluid. Important that both should be done at the same time. The values that you are taking, the sample should be at the same time. What is the cutoff value to call high SAG or low SAG? It is 1.1. Again, to remember this, what is the cutoff value for high versus low? SAG mein you have double A. A is your first alphabet. Remember AA is 1.1. So that is your 1.1. So if SAG is more than 1.1, it is high gradient. It is due to portal hypertension. If SAG is less than 1.1, it is low gradient. That means it is not due to portal hypertension. Okay, that means it is not due to portal hypertension. So look at the causes here. SAG more than or equal to 1.1. are all your causes of portal hypertension, like you see here, cirrhosis, Bacciari syndrome, massive liver metastasis, heart failure, the back pressure to the liver, IVC obstruction is what type of portal hypertension? Is it prehepatic, posthepatic, intrahepatic? What type of portal hypertension is IVC obstruction? IVC obstruction. So you have the liver, you have the portal vein, and then you have the hepatic veins, IVC. After the liver, it comes IVC. So that is your post-hepatic, right? That is your post-hepatic portal hypertension. Sinusoidal obstruction syndrome is basically your post-sinusoidal but intrahepatic portal hypertension. Okay, post-sinusoidal intrahepatic. Now, all these are causes of your portal hypertension, be it prehepatic or intrahepatic or posthepatic. Now, the next thing that we look at is whether your ascitic protein is less than 2.5 or ascitic protein is more than 2.5. Once you know that this is high SAG, you know it's portal hypertension. Now, to narrow down the differential of portal hypertension, what could be the cause of portal hypertension? You look at the ascitic protein. If the ascitic protein is less, that means basically your protein in the body is less. Protein comes from the liver. Your albumin is synthesized in liver. So basically it is your liver function which is compromised, right? It's your liver wala cause of portal hypertension. Like your cirrhosis, the liver parenchyma is affected. Very important, remember this is your late Bacciari syndrome when the liver parenchyma is also affected. Early Bacciari syndrome, liver parenchyma is not affected. The ascitic protein is high. Late mein, liver parenchyma affected, ascitic protein is less. Massive liver metastasis, again your liver parenchyma is affected, ascitic protein will be less. Ascitic protein will be high when your liver is not affected. Like your cardiac cause, the constrictive pericarditis, heart failure, your IVC obstruction, early Bacciari syndrome, or even your sinusoidal obstruction syndrome. Basically your vascular cause, like your early Bacciari, IVC, sinusoidal, or your cardiac cause, where the liver is not affected. In that, you will have the ascitic protein, which is high, because liver is normal. So the proteins will be normal. When do you have low SAG? That is your non-portal hypertension wale causes. So to remember the causes of low SAG, remember it is bina portal hypertension. That is your non-portal hypertension. Bina, B is your BI, you have your biliary leak, you have your nephrotic syndrome, that is bina portal hypertension. You have PNT, that is your pancreatitis, peritoneal carcinomatosis and tuberculosis. All of these, they do not cause your portal hypertension. So biliary leak, nephrotic, pancreatitis, peritoneal carcinomatosis, tuberculosis, these are your SARG less than 1.1. Okay, these are your SARG less than 1.1. Everyone clear so far? So the mnemonic for your low SARG, low matlab no portal hypertension. That is your no portal hypertension. That is bina portal hypertension, biliary, nephrotic, pancreatitis, peritoneal and tuberculosis. Right? Can you tell me one cause where you have high SARG, okay, where you have high SARG without portal hypertension? We said that when it is high SARG, you think of portal hypertension. But let's say that a patient comes with ascites and you look at the SARG comes out to be high. Then you do further evaluation, but there is nothing which indicates portal hypertension. Anything which can have high SARG without portal hypertension? Anything which can have high SARG without portal hypertension? Very correct. Absolutely right. That is your urinary bladder rupture. So basically ascites, the fluid is coming into the peritoneal cavity but not from the hepatic sinusoids, not because of portal hypertension but from somewhere else, and that somewhere else is basically when the urinary bladder ruptures. So the urine goes out and that causes your ascites, and it is your ascites with high SARG. Okay, congestive heart failure will cause portal hypertension. Your liver metastasis can lead to portal hypertension. The question is without portal hypertension, that is your urinary bladder rupture. And how will we diagnose this? Because the urine is going out. So in the peritoneal fluid, in the ascites, you will have high creatinine, right? That will be present in the ascites. So that is how you will diagnose the ascites due to urinary bladder rupture, right? Now, if I ask you the next question, in nephrotic syndrome, okay, in nephrotic syndrome, how will be the SARG and how will be the total ascites protein? These are the two things that we need to look at. How will be the SARG? Is it low or is it high? How is SARG value in your nephrotic syndrome? Low or high? High SARG, remember, means is your portal hypertension. Low SARG is your no portal hypertension. Nephrotic syndrome, there's no portal hypertension, so SARG will be low. Low matlab less than 1.1. And how would be the total ascites protein? Total ascites protein will be less than 2.5 or more than 2.5. Now, since in nephrotic syndrome, you have protein urea, right? Even though the liver function is normal, but the protein is getting excreted. So that is why the protein will be less. So remember here, less protein is because of protein urea, not because of the liver function getting affected. Okay. So there will be total ascites protein will be less. So remember, both less is your nephrotic syndrome. Okay. Both less is your nephrotic syndrome. So let us quickly see this table here. SARG, low SARG, high SARG. High SARG is your portal hypertension. High SARG with your low protein, less than 2.5, right? That is what basically is your quadrant here. Okay, so we are drawing like a quadrant here. So if this is the SARG that you have on the x-axis, this is the total ascites protein. This one, negative, negative wala, that means low SARG, low total ascites protein. Low SARG means your non-portal hypertension. Low total ascites protein, that is like your nephrotic syndrome, right? That will be your nephrotic syndrome. So their nephrotic syndrome comes in your this less. When you have high total ascites protein and you have your low SARG, low SARG with high ascites protein is your other causes of non-portal hypertension, like your cancer, TB, chylus, pancreatitis. When you have both high SARG with high proteins, that is your portal hypertension without affecting the liver, okay, not your hepatic causes. So that is your vascular and cardiac causes, right? That is your vascular and cardiac causes. So early Bacchiari syndrome, right heart failure, your veno-occlusive disease, these will come here. High SAG with low total ascites protein is portal hypertension, where the liver parenchyma is affected. So like your cirrhosis and the late Bacchiari syndrome. Okay, cirrhosis and late Bacchiari. Is it understood by everyone? So your SAG and your total proteins. So this is what we discussed, a rare cause of ascites with elevated SAG. It's without your portal hypertension, without your increase in hydrostatic or your oncotic pressure, is urinary bladder rupture when the urine leaks into the peritoneal space. Okay, so this is a question for you to solve. Tell me, what do you think will be the answer to this question? So lengthy question, the clue is always read from the last line. Which of the following is the most likely cause of the patient's ascites? You are given serum albumin, you are given ascites albumin and ascites protein. I've given you all the clues. I think I'm hiding this, the values. So let me take the values here. Can't see the values, that is what I said. So just give me a minute. Can you see the values now? You can solve it and then I'll be back. So I have hidden myself till then. So what do you think will be the answer to this question? So I can see majority of you getting this right. That's super amazing. Very good. Now let us try and solve this question. Now that every one of you have seen this, let us try and solve this question. Okay. Now whenever you are given this, what is the cause of ascites? Look at your SAG values first. SAG is your serum ascites albumin gradient. So serum albumin is 3.6 here. Ascites albumin is 1.1. It is 2.5 is the SAG value. More than 1.1. So this is basically your high SAG. Okay, this is your high SAG. When this is high SAG, SAG matlab palak, that is your portal hypertension. So which options are ruled out? Your intraperitoneal tumor is ruled out, tuberculosis is ruled out, because this is non-portal hypertension. Now you know that it could be acute Bacchiari, cirrhosis or heart failure. Look at the total ascites protein, 0.9, which is less than 2.5. The total ascites protein is less. Total ascites protein is less. When the protein is less, that means it is the liver parenchyma which is affected. That means it is not your vascular or cardiac cause. Acute Bacchiari, vascular wala cause, abhi nahi, early mein nahi, late mein hota hai. Heart failure is out. It is your cirrhosis. Why some of you are saying heart failure? Heart failure causes portal hypertension? Yes, it is increased SAG. Does it affect the liver parenchyma function? No. So the total ascites protein will be more than 2.5. Here it is less than 2.5. So the answer is your cirrhosis. Okay, the answer is cirrhosis. Is this clear with everyone? How will you approach such questions? Acute Bacchiari, liver parenchyma is not affected. It's in your late Bacchiari. So here also the total ascites protein will be more than 2.5. Okay, it will be more than 2.5. Is this clear? Right? Okay. Now let's come to the final table. Total protein ascites ka hai. It's given here. Ascites protein. If I am again hiding this. So here it is given. Ascites protein is 0.9. You have to see the total ascites protein. Alright? Okay. Now let us complete this final table here. SAG and your total ascites protein. Tell me, what will be your cirrhosis? Will it be high SAG, high TAP, low SAG, low TAP, high SAG, low TAP? What will be your cirrhosis? Is it high, 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 low, low, low? What will be your cirrhosis? Mein kya hoga? So whenever you are asked, start thinking, does this cause portal hypertension? Does this affect your liver function? You have to just ask these two questions, portal hypertension versus liver function. Portal hypertension cirrhosis, yes, SAG palak, so that will be your high SAG. Liver function is affected, so protein synthesis will be affected, so this will be high and low, right? Early Bacciari syndrome, what will be the findings in early Bacciari? Early Bacciari, will it be high, 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 low, low, low? What will be your early Bacciari syndrome? Very correct. Early Bacciari, portal hypertension, yes. So it's gonna be your increased SAG. Early Bacciari, liver function is not affected. So the total ascites protein will be high. It will be more than 2.5. So it will be high, high. Please read carefully. This is early. While in your late Bacciari, it will be your portal hypertension, yes. Liver function also affected. So this is your low total ascites protein. So for your SAG, basically you need to ask portal hypertension. Agar hai, to high SAG. Liver function if affected, that is your low ascites protein. Okay. What will happen in your CCF, congestive cardiac failure? It causes portal hypertension, but liver function is not affected. So is it high, 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 low? What is it? Portal hypertension? Yes. So increased SAG. Liver function affected? No. It is not the liver which is affected. So total ascites protein will be high, right? The total ascites protein will be high because the liver function, the liver parenchyma is not affected. What will happen in tuberculosis? Tuberculosis, a cause of portal hypertension? No. So this is going to be your low SAG, right? This is going to be your low SAG. Ascites protein in tuberculosis, remember, it can be anything. It can be high as well, it can be low as well. Okay, it can be high as well or it can be low as well. Okay. Yes. Coming to nephrotic syndrome, what will you see in nephrotic syndrome? What will you see in nephrotic syndrome? Nephrotic, portal hypertension, no. So no is your low SAG. Okay, no is your low. No portal hypertension is low SAG. Total ascites protein, because there is proteinuria, will be less. Okay, this will be less because of the proteinuria. Okay, because of the proteinuria. Next one, pancreatitis. What will happen in pancreatitis? Portal hypertension? No. So that means it is going to be your pancreatitis, no portal hypertension, low SAG. Liver function not affected, the proteins is going to be high. Okay, the proteins is going to be high. What will you see in IVC obstruction? What will you see in IVC obstruction? IVC obstruction, it's a post-hepatic cause of portal hypertension, yes. So it's gonna be high SAG. But the liver function is not affected, so the total ascites protein will not be low, it will be high. So it will be high, high. It's a post-hepatic cause. Sinusoidal obstruction syndrome. It is your high SAG because it is portal hypertension and it's a vascular obstruction wala cause. It is total ascites protein will be high. So even in sinusoidal obstruction, you will have high and high. Okay, that will be high SAG and high total ascites protein. So this was about this session on your SAG value. So you only need to ask two questions, whether this is a cause of portal hypertension and whether the liver protein synthesis is affected or no. Okay, so if there is portal hypertension, then it is your high SAG. If no, it is low SAG. If the liver protein synthesis is affected, yes, then it's going to be your low total ascites protein. And even in your protein urea, it will be your low total ascites protein, like in your nephrotic syndrome. High SAG without portal hypertension is your urinary bladder rupture. Okay. So I have this final image for you. So can you see in this CT scan? This is a CT scan. You see the white bones here. This is a coronal CT. These are your iliac bones. These are the vertebra. Look at the arrow here. If I zoom this image, the arrow basically shows a discontinuity in the bladder wall. And what do you see in the CT scan? What is all this which we are seeing here? All this which you are seeing here, this gray color, that is the fluid. Okay, that is basically your ascites. Okay, all this is ascites. And the arrow tells you that the cause of ascites is your urinary bladder rupture. Okay, that's your urinary bladder rupture. So how will be the SAG in this case? If they tell you that, how will be the SAG will be high. It is your high SAG. The fluid, the water is coming from the urinary bladder. That's gonna be your high SAG. Okay, that is your high SAG. All right. So that's about the session, guys, on your society lights criteria. I'll try and include in one of the upcoming sessions. As I said, the plan for the tomorrow's 9:30, the rank booster series, is a quick recap of your cartilage from your anatomy, from your histology. A quick recap of cartilage, the types of cartilage, how do you identify histology images of hyaline, elastic and your fibrocartilage. I'll tell you some quick tips. Next, I am meeting the Unacademy Plus subscribers at 11 a.m. which is your mnemonics batch. And today, because we have pharmac in our target, we will be seeing your general pharmacologic and numericals. So please be very, very attentive during the class. There's going to be a lot of mathematics. The numericals is what we are going to see in the 11 a.m. class. And for all of you who are unaware, so we have on Unacademy, we have launched a 1 month subscription as well to help in your 1 month NEET PG preparation. So you can take 1 month subscription till your exam. And by using the code, you can use the code Dr. Nikita and you can get additional 10% discount while you are subscribing. So if you think that helps you in your preparation, you can definitely consider that 1 month or subscription. Okay. So first question. Now let me go back to the first question, Nishu. What was the first question? So ascites with low SAG value, I'm sure all of you know this now. Ascites with low SAG, low means no portal hypertension, that is your peritoneal carcinomatosis. Rest of them are causes of portal hypertension. So this is your high SAG. Okay, that's your high SAG. 5 p.m. topic today is emergency case discussion, the one which was posted on YouTube channel. So a very, very high yielding discussion based around that case will be done. Half an hour class at 5 p.m. today. Okay. So thank you so much everyone for joining in for the session. I hope the concept of your serum ascites albumin gradient is now clear and simplified. You know, only two questions to ask: whether there is portal hypertension, whether the liver function is affected. That is what you need to ask to solve these questions. All right. So goodbye. Take care. Keep studying, keep revising and keep winning. And let's meet at 11 a.m. on the Unacademy.